Okay, so please be welcome to the Neuro Media Home deep dive session. And so Neuro Media Home is your all-in-one media manager. And first thing we should do in a media manager is to import some media to it. As you can see on the screen, it starts with some demo content, but actually we want to have our own stuff in, and that's what we will do now. So we can remove the demo content from the media library and add some more stuff. We start with pictures first. So you can define for each folder you import if there are photos, videos, and music included. And of course, one folder can also have different media types inside, but for this one it only has photos, so I only choose photos and I import them. So what you are seeing now is a progress bar here. And Neuro Media Home will go through all the pictures we just added and will create nice thumbnail view for you. On the right you can see the date when the stuff was recorded. With these buttons here or small bullets, you see if there's a lot of content, the bullet is a bit bigger. If it's a smaller amount of content, it's smaller. So we have now a couple of years imported and it's still generating thumbnails. But even while this is ongoing, you can already browse the library. And you see, here's it ongoing. You go up, so we have some nice photos. And you can already note there's a little red thing here in the corner, which is the geotagging indicator. Well, that means basically these photos have places information. They are done with the iPhone. And this is one of the nice features actually. You can expand this sidebar and see immediately where the photo was shot. And if the photo has no such information, you can also edit later. But we will come to this. First, the importing. So that's about the photos. Now let's also throw in some videos. So here you need to go to the options. There's also a mode for automatic import, but I always use this one because it's more under control for me, everything. I don't like the automatic stuff. For videos, there's a special thing. You can have my videos or your personal videos, but you can have also folders with movies and TV shows. So this one is also videos I shot with my iPhone, and they will also be imported. And of course, you can add zillions of photos and videos. Of course, the process will take longer then, but overall, Neuro Media Home is really made to support a lot of files in there. So we have users, they have 200,000 music files or 20, 30, 40 gigabytes of photos, and it's no problem at all. So let's see, that's about the videos. We have a slideshow module. To this we come later. We also have music in here. So again, we add some music here. And again, this is all demo data. And just to show you the process in general. Can see it's already displaying the music in a nice also with the cover art and everything. And there are two items. It's still loading. Okay. Now it found even everything. Okay. So in the background we're using a service that's called Gracenote, who will find cover art for all the files and display it very nicely here in an album view. Let's go to movies. That's a feature we just recently added. Now I have a couple of movies in here. And there you can see, though the background is black, so we have for movies and TV shows, because they are more on, you watch them maybe on the bigger monitor. We added some black background. And actually, you see the pictures you see here, it's not the actual content I have added, no? So it's just a placeholder, a thumbnail in the back. But it doesn't matter, because actually what we want to see is what's ongoing here now. And that's basically that now Nero Meteor Home is checking, based on the file name of the file, no? which movie it is, and is actually downloading the movie cover. So as you can see, we use a website for this, no? Who has basically all movies in the world registered to this website, and so we can easily get the cover, the poster, the film poster, and some information about the movie. And as you can see, that's much nicer than to have the thumbnails that have been there. And the same is possible even for TV shows. So in TV shows, there is the special thing. It's not like movies, so one movie each. It's TV shows is about you have seasons and episodes. No? So there's even a kind of sorting of seasons and episodes. You can see this here. We have some again some demo content in here. And you can see it's on the top level, it shows how many episodes are in there in total. So for this Miami Vice, for example, no, 111, so that's actually the complete series. No? So all episodes that are available from Miami Vice are in here in the library. And now the same process applies like in the movies, that now it will start to download all the covers, and for episodes it's also thumbnails. No? So now you see Games of Thrones, it's detected, it's from 2011. You go inside, you see I have season 1, I have the 10, and then for each of the, of course there are no album art for episodes, no? So here you actually see one thumbnail out of each episode. Okay, so we will let this running, because it still takes a while, and come back in a second. Okay, now we have seen how to import some stuff into Nero Meteor Home that's actually already on your hard disk. So now let's see how we can get more stuff in. One thing you can try, there's an app, it's called Nero Meteor Home Wi-Fi Sync. So you can install it on your Android phone or on your iPhone. And if you launch the app, which I'm just doing, then actually your device will become available in Nero Meteor Home quickly. So it's just setting up the connection, and you will see. Magically it appears here in Nero Meteor Home. So this is without any USB cable. Of course you can always use a USB cable, but in this case we just use the free Nero Meteor Home Wi-Fi Sync app, and it's actually pretty fast and works pretty well. So you can see now all the content of my new phone. It's also separated in photos and videos, and now I can go here, select a few of the items and say import. It will ask me if I want to put it in the album, what should be the name of the album, and everything will be transferred wirelessly from my phone onto the hard disk. And then of course it will also show up in Nero Meteor Home in the media library. And we already created our first item, which is an album, which is one of the many ways you can actually do something with your media in Nero Meteor Home. So you see, here's the album 01. So you could have named it also like Christmas Market or whatever content you have in there. and so you can easily find your photos again later on. So the next thing I want to show is importing of an audio CD. So I just attached a drive and insert an audio CD. So Neuro Media Home will now browse it and actually also play it. And you see all the titles in there. And again, it's the Gracenote metadata stuff is included. So it already shows how the files are named. And the next thing I want to do is import the disk. So you press stop after the disk started to play, and then it will provide you nicely with some options like import tracks. So I want to import a couple of the tracks from this CD. And that's what we just do. So that's just another way of adding more stuff to your library. And actually you can do this with all your files or all your disks you have at home. You can just one after the other throw it in and rip it to your hard disk. So next time you use your laptop without the optical disk drive, you have all your music with you. And then, as you have seen, the Neuro Media Home Wi-Fi Sync. So actually, you can not only import with Neuro Media Home Wi-Fi Sync, but you can also drag and drop now stuff from your media library to your Android phone and to your iOS phone, and it will be transferred. And so you have your music even with you all the time. Of course, it's also possible to import media from external devices like USB sticks and hard disks. I just plug in a big USB stick here. And basically it's the same like with the Wi-Fi Sync app. You will see all the content on the device and you will be able to import stuff. What is especially important is this bar here, because you can either import the stuff, in this case it will be copied to your local hard disk, but you can also add the stick to your library, similar to the stuff you added before. No? For example, I can say add to media library, and then I will always see the media on the stick also in my media library. Even if the stick is unplugged, I can show it here. So now it's creating again the thumbnails from all the medias on the stick. So we will let this finish. Again, some files with geodata on the stick. Oh, here we are. So basically, USB sticks, hard disks, even NAS drives can be added to your media library. So even if they are not permanently attached to your PC or to your network, you can still add them, which is a nice principle of this media library concept. So you will see the data here. And now I will simply remove the stick from the PC, and you will see what happens. All the files are still there, they just get a little red flag, which means the file is offline. But still, you know it's there, and you can find out on which stick it is, and so on. And if you reinsert the stick or your hard disk, the red flag will go away, and you will be able to use your files and open them and edit them as before. And of course, if you want to get rid of anything that's on a stick or something which you don't have anymore, you don't want to see into your library anymore, you can always go to the settings, remove it, remove the folder or the stick, and the stuff will disappear from your library. Okay, so now we have imported quite a lot of stuff into our media library, and now finally we can do some things with the stuff. And the first thing we want to do is search for single items. So I will just collapse the sidebar a little bit to make it look more nice. And as you have maybe noticed here, we have different views here. So the default view is the timeline, where you see all your photos in a chronological order. But we also have faces here. Faces is a feature which you can turn on here with this button. And then it will go through all of your photos and look for faces in the photo. And so again, this is a process you need to do once, and then afterwards you will have the benefit of all the faces in your library being identified, and you will be able to easily name them and find more people with the same face, look for photos with people with certain names on it, and it will all make your library more meaningful and more easy to use. So for example, this is little Mary, well, so I can give names here directly. And so we have a place where the people are where we gave already names, and I go inside and I can see that the program already has detected two pictures of Mary, and we can even let the full pictures be displayed here, no? So we can either have Mary, or we can have it, you can see the full picture here. And so you can do this for all your friends and family. Let's see, there's another one. This is Liza. And you can see Liza is also on these two pictures. And so now you can go on through all your pictures. And this is a very important screen, because actually it's not, face recognition is not 100% always correct, no? So sometimes there are pictures, no? Because it's an algorithm, no? It's actually pretty hard for a computer to detect the face, and you can have different lighting situations and whatever, no? So it can happen that Mary or Lisa are here again and they are not recognized, and then you can just simply use drag and drop to add them to the group. And the algorithm will get smarter over time, no? So if you add more people of Liza and Mary to it, next time they will be recognized much more easily. So you can do this for all your family. And as you will see later in the Find tab, this will make it very easy to find pictures with certain people on it. There's also a tab called Places, and it will allow you to show where the photos have been taken. So I have photos here, they are taken with the iPhone, and so it has place data, and I can see that these pictures are actually the airport in Frankfurt. And I can also go to other places, and it will just zoom in, and I can see that these photos are taken, for example, in Los Angeles. And I also have pictures they have no place data, because for example they have been shot with a GoPro camera. And if I want to add a place here, I just select the picture, I enter the location, this is the West Lake in China, and then the item will be placed on the map, and it will also have the tag, and you can see that it will be added to the respective group. So there's a fourth tab which allows you to easily find pictures. For example, it will show you here on top a cloud of all the tags which you already have. There are the name tags you already applied, there are the places included. Also, if you had some folder names on your hard disk when you imported the stuff which had some meaningful names, then it's very easy to filter now pictures according to your purpose. For example, we go to Los Angeles here, and I see now all pictures from Los Angeles, and I can even narrow it down to a picture where Paula is on, and it will nicely give me exactly the picture I was looking for. So as a next step, we want to do a little slideshow. So I check my pictures here I want to use for the slideshow. And I mark the ones I want to use. There's this little yellow indicator here. So we have something from the West Lake here. We have something from this temple, which is nice. There's also a cooking show event here. That's nice, yes. Okay, and then from the, I can go here and see all my marked pictures, and I can just tag them and say, okay, from this picture, create a slideshow. The city is called Hangzhou in China. So I will create now a slideshow. So I have the four pictures, and okay, maybe I want to have a little bit more stuff. Maybe I also have a nice video from there. So I go back to my media library and check it out. Oh, actually, this is a nice video and I want to have it in my slideshow also. So I click Add to Slideshow and add it to the Hangzhou slideshow. This brings me back to the slideshow editing. So actually that's my LA slideshow, but I want to check out the Hangzhou slideshow. And I go here. The nice thing about slideshows in your Mediahome is that you don't have to do anything. You just drag in the stuff and then you select a nice little theme. So I have three installed, but actually there are also 50 more in a thing that's called the content pack. So if you have it installed, you will see 50 different options. And now you can see it will create a full slideshow with music and nice animations right out of my pictures and videos. With a few clicks you have a nice little slideshow and you can watch it in your Mediahome, you can export it as a file, and you can even hand over it to Nero Video, where you can do some more advanced editing. So you can, for example, apply some special effects to each picture and so on. So the full Nero Video editing capabilities are possible for the slideshow also. So in your Mediahome you also have some photo editing capabilities. So let's take a picture here, for example this one. You can view it in full screen. And then there's also an edit photo option. And a good thing is, and this is noted here in the screen, which you see when you first time use it, so it's non-destructive. So whatever you do to your photo, the original photo will be saved, and you can always go back to it. No? So you can apply some cropping here. Say, I don't like the other stuff, I want to have it more like this. If the photo is not straight, no, you can also rotate it a little bit. More like this. If you had red eyes included, you can remove them. You can also adjust the exposure a little bit to make it look more sharp or crisp. You also have the all the settings to change the color temperature. No? So, it was a warm night, so it should look more like this. And even some effects you can apply with the preview. So you have sharpen effect, glow, and there's also some vignette stuff. You can make look like an old video or a photo. And you can even apply one effect over the other. And if you go now back, the photo will be like this in your media library. but at any time you can, you see it here, it will apply all the effects here. But if at some point you decide, ah, I don't like the changes I applied here, you can always go back to photo editing and revert to original, will bring you back the original photo. So you don't need to be afraid to destroy anything while doing this. So Nero Media Home also comes with a smaller view, which is called the Nero Media Browser. And actually there you see all the media files. The same way you have them in Nero Media Home. And the good thing is that from there you can basically use it with every Windows desktop application you might have. For example, you have WordPad here. You have the same categories, everything, faces, places, everything is there. And then you can just use drag and drop to add photos and videos and music and movies to whatever Windows application you would like. So it's not like that Nero Media Home is just a small or a system where it's in itself, no, where you can have all the stuff, but there are also interfaces to the outside world, so you don't need to do your photo editing in Media Home. If you prefer another application, you can just drag and drop it and it will become available in the other application for using it. Another way of accessing your files and media library from Nero Media Home is to use your smartphone. So you can use the free Nero Streaming Player app for iOS and Android, and it will find your Nero Media Home on the PC. And actually you will see you have exactly the same categories there like you have on the PC. So you have photos, my videos, my slideshows, my music, movies and TV shows. And so you can browse it there and play it exactly the same way like you have the stuff on your PC. And you can even go from there and stream it to another TV, for example, or any other DLNA UPnP compatible device. And even your slideshows are there. So if you created it in Nero Media Home, you will see it here and you will be able to play it on your mobile phone or on your iPad, for example. So you have the same experience regardless in Nero Media Home, Nero Media Browser, or on your mobile device. So Nero wouldn't be Nero if there would not be some burning options in Nero Media Home. For example, I can go here, select my nice slideshow we just created, and burn it to a disk. So we have the option to burn DVD video, AVC HD, we can also do data disks and even copy disks. We can also do audio CDs in Nero Media Home and data disk with some photos and videos on it. And if you have attached a Blu-ray recorder, you can even record Blu-rays. So we go in here, select our nice slideshow, insert an empty disk, and go to burn. That's all we have to do. And Nero Media Home will make the slideshow to the disk with a nice default menu, which looks good. And so this is a very easy and convenient way to create a DVD to give to your grandma for Christmas, for example, or any other use cases. So now we are getting to the end of our session today. One thing we still want to point out is you might have asked yourself, okay, now I spent so much time in Nero Media Home, I added tags to all my photos, I put tags on the places and faces and everything, and made a very nice thing. I edited pictures, I applied effects, I even created a lot of slideshows. I sorted all my music, my movies and my TV shows. So what happens if I want to switch my PC, or my PC gets a virus and everything is lost? How can I restore this nice media library? We also have an option for this. So you go to the settings, and there is a thing called library copy. And you go copy library, and it informs you that Nero Media Home will be closed while you're doing this. And you see there is a little copy and paste wizard available. And all you have to do is to insert an external hard disk to make the backup to. So I just attach the hard disk. It will show up in a second here. And you can see on the left, you see how much photos, videos and so on you have, and how big the files are. And now you can decide if you want to back up the library with all the photos, music and videos, or you can also do a backup of just the media library, which is actually not that big. So that's all the tags, all the faces, all the places, all the thumbnails. So for this demo, I will just do this. And you see it goes pretty fast and smoothly. And Nero Media Home starts again afterwards. And in case something should happen to your PC, or you want to move your PC and meet to a new PC, and you have a new Nero Media Home, you can always go here, select Paste Library, and the backup will be found, and you can just paste it to your new PC, and everything will be as it was before. Thanks for listening.